All right, guys, anime speed lines. This is a two-part tutorial, so let's get to it. You got your black solid here, like normal black solid like you normally have for any layer. So all you gotta do is click on effect up here, go all the way down to noise and grain, and go to fractal noise. Click on that. As soon as you do that, you see this little smoky thing here. That's cool. Let's look at the menu here on the effects. It's fractal type, basic, totally cool. Noise type, soft linear, totally cool. Where you start tweaking things is contrast. You're gonna move the contrast up to 150. And then the brightness, you're gonna go negative 45 or negative 50, whatever you want. Leave overflow alone. Transform, click down on that. And then one thing you really have to do is click on uniform scaling. You wanna uncheck that box. As soon as I uncheck it here, it opens up scale width and scale height. I'll click on scale width, type in 2000. Starting to look like anime lines, cool. And scale height, bring it down to 20. And it starts looking like thinner anime lines, which is pretty cool. Offset turbulence, leave it alone. Complexity, leave it alone. The place where you wanna start going and doing cool stuff is evolution. You wanna make sure your playhead is here at the beginning. Click on the stopwatch for evolution and then go to the end of your playhead. And then you're gonna set another keyframe by typing immediately here. I don't know, I'll type in like 60. And here I'm gonna go all the way up to 100 and something degrees. And I'll press play here, you can see. It's already starting to look like anime lines. Pretty cool, right? Awesome. So then you click on a black solid. You want to duplicate it. Press Apple D. And then you only want to change transform scale height here. So instead of being 20, we're going to make that 50. And you're going to see it made it much, much bigger now. And that's totally fine. Then you're going to click up here. Click on rounded rectangle tool to make a mask. And then you're going to create a mask right around here. And that's just to make the center of the anime lines look bigger, which creates a tunnel effect, which is kind of cool. And then you want to go to mask and feather that bad boy quite a bit so that, you know, it merges with the rest of the animation. So I'll click out of that here, and as soon as you see it, check it out. It's pretty cool, right? Awesome. So now we're going to go into part two of creating this, but first, we're gonna pre-compose these bad boys. So just select these two here and press Shift Apple C to pre-compose, click OK. And now we're gonna go into section two.